Welcome to e-learning program of Modern International School Hiswa. I am Asif, your mathematics teacher. This is class 7, chapter name decimals. Only we will present over here to revise the decimal chapter of exercise 3C. So in this video session, friends, we will discuss about some of the questions as a revision purpose of exercise 3C. And the first question is here, friends, question number 8 says evaluate, because question 8 has 4 sub questions, 1, 2nd, 3rd and the 4th, and we have taken as 2 question, we have taken 2 question as question number 1, 0.3 raised to the power 3 and 0.04 to the power 2. Now see, friends, what does it means? First of all, see, friends, the solution here, how to solve this one? Here 0.3 raised to the power 3. So the numbers carrying as a power 3, that means this number 0.3 decimals can be multiplied 3 times itself. Okay, 0.3 3 times. Now, friends, multiply their numerical values. 3 3s are 9 and 9 3s are 27. Okay. Now, count the number of digits after decimal. So, here the number of digit after decimal is the 1 digit. Here is also 1 digit. 1 digit. 1, 1 and 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, friends, this is 3. That means we have to place the decimal after counting 3 digits from right hand side. From right to left, we will go from right to left and counting 3 digits, 1, 2, but here is only 2 digits, friends. Now what will be the clue? First, and we have to place, we have to stick this 0 before 2 and we will get 3 digits, and then count 1, 2 and 3 and place the point, and here there is a standard form, this 0. So this is your answer, friend. Now come to the next question, friend. Here question number 3rd. 0.04 raised to the power 2. That means the say this number could be written as 2 times as multiplicative form. That means 0.04 multiplied by 0.04 2 times. Why 2 times? Because the power is 2. This is why we are going to write as a multiplicative form as 2 times. Now multiply their numerical values only. 4 4 ja first 16, friends, and remember. So what is the role of decimal? Here is the decimal. Now this is not the correct answer. Now in order to correct answer, first of all count the number of digits after decimal. So here this is the decimal number with 2 decimal places, and this is also decimal with the 2 decimal places. Here is the 2 digits, here is the 2 decimal, means 2 or 2, 4. 4 digits. Now friends, we have to count the 4 digits from right hand side and put the decimal, but here is only 2 digits. Now friends, then what we do? Yes, that means we place the 2 times 0 and this became the 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and place the 0 for the standard, write the 0. So this is your answer. I hope you will be clear. Now next one is, now friends, see question number 11. This is the a statement type of question, means what's problem. Very simple, friend. First we will have to understand what does it mean, what they are going to understand. Okay, what we are going to make understand, what we have to see, we have to understand, and we have to find the clue, and we have to find the clue for solving a problem. Now here the question number 11, as you can see the question number 11 on the screen, that a bag of wheat weighs 97.8 kg. How much wheat is contained in 500 such bags? Very simple, friends. See, the first, write the first statement. Here is the a bag of wheat weighs 97.8 kg. 97.8 kg. Now friends, see, first the first statement says, since बैग कंटेन्स वीट वेट 97.8 kg, मीन्स एक बोरी में कितना वीट गेहूं है और 97.8 kg। तो हम मुझे फाइंड क्या करना था, 500 ऐसे बैग्स में कितने किलो गेहूं आ सकता है। तो सिंपल 500 से मल्टीप्लाई करना है सिंपली, सो दिस इज वाई वी हैव रिटेन, देयरफॉर 500 बैग्स कंटेन वीट वेट 97.8 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 500। नाउ इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई नाउ वी विल गेट फ्रेंड्स 48900. Now friends, here the count number of digit after decimal. Here the one digit and here is the only one digit. Okay. Now friends, we have to place the decimal after counting two digits. One digit from right hand side. Here is the one. One is here. So the answer is 4892 times zero. Here is the decimal. So after decimal, there is no important of zero. So this is why we can erase this zero. This is your answer, friends. KG. Now see friends, question number 13 says, a small bottles hold 0.845 kg of sugar, how much sauce will be there in 72 such bottles? Simply we have to multiply only a small bottle, means one bottle carries 0.845 kg. Now since one is small, whatever the small or big, there is no matter at all, a small bottle holds 0.845 kg sugar. Okay. Now, इसलिए therefore 72 bottles hold 0.845 multiply by 72 kg sugar. Okay. Now we have to multiply 845 by 72. 5 to get 10, 0, 1 is balance. 4 to get 9, 8 to get 16. 7, 5 to 35, 5, 3 is balance. 7, 4 to 28, 28, 3, 31st to 1, 3 is balance. And 8, 7 to 56, 56. 56 plus 3, this is 59. So this 0, 14, 1 is balance, 7, 8, 0, or this is 5. So friends, the multiplication is 50840. Now bus friends, here is the decimal. So count the number of digits after decimal. Here is the 1, 2, 3, 3 digits. Now we have to place the counting 3 digits from right hand side. Here the 1, 2, 3 place. So this is KZ. I hope you will understand friends. Now you can multiply and check is it right or wrong. Okay. See friend, the same question is over here. Question number 15 says, if one drum can hold 16.850 liters oil, how many liters can 48 such drums hold? Very simple. Now the solution is, here first write the one in numerical. One drum can hold liters in oil. One drum can hold oil is equal to 16.850 liter, L4 liter. Okay. Now इसलिए therefore we have to find the 48 drums can, one drum holds 48 drums can hold, HOLD, hold oil is equal to 48 multiply by 16.850 liter. Now multiply friend, 16.850, remove the zero, this is 48. Now multiply here. Now see friends, after multiplying these two numbers we will get 808 point, because the number of digits is 3 after decimal. So count the 1, 2, 3, this here the decimal. So this is answer. I hope you will get. Now see friends, question number 19 says, a taxi driver charges 9.80 rupees per kg, how much will he charge for a journey of 106.5 kg. Simple friends, when a taxi drives, when he reaches the 1 kilometer and he will charge 9.80 rupees, yani 9.80 rupees for 1 kilometer. Okay, now we can write the charge of in one kilometer the charge of taxi in 1 kilometer the charge of taxi is equal to 9.80 rupees. Okay, therefore 106.5 kilometer, so the charge of taxi is equal to this multiply by, only we have to multiply, 106.5 rupees. Okay, now multiply friends, first multiply their numerical value and removing the decimals, then place the decimal after counting the number of decimal places, whatever the number of decimal places they have. Okay, then you will get the answer. I hope you can easy multiply and place the decimal. Suppose here the number of decimal places, here the 2, here the 3, 1, 2 plus 1, 3, and we have to count whatever the number after multiplying you will get. Count the number of digits from right hand side, number of 3 digits. We have to count the number of 3 digits from right hand side and place the decimal, and this will give us your answer. I hope you are getting and understood. Now your homework friends, question number 8 to 19. Okay, please revise carefully, solve as well. Have a nice day.